Hi everyone, Nick here. I realized last week that I posted a video about how to transform a normal clustered bar chart into this really cool back-to-back bar chart. But there was one part of that video that I failed to mention, and it's how you position the axis appropriately, the y-axis or the vertical axis. So if you're following along on that video at home, you probably found that when you switched the bars so that they started overlapping, the axis, this y-axis right here, the vertical axis, was right here in the center of the chart along the zero point. We obviously don't want that. We want these labels to be over here on the left side. And so I realized that that was a little bit of a trick that I had because I was practicing beforehand. And so I had already formatted my axis label correctly. So I want to show you some of the different positioning that you can add to this axis, because you can actually position the axis either on the end of the chart on the left-hand side, the right-hand side, or in the middle next to the axis. And I'm going to show you how to do that right here. So you're going to click on the axis, right-click Format Axis, there, if your format axis pane is not already open, and you're going to scroll all the way down here to the little caret drop-down menu that says labels. So in that labels, we're going to go to the label position right here. I'm going to see if I can like pull this out just a little bit more. There's a little drop-down here that says next to axis. So it's going to default to next to axis. You're always going to be next to axis. If we went over here to our clustered bar chart right here, you can see that it's always going to be there next to axis. That's probably what it's going to be if you create your own clustered bar chart. But once you swap the bars, they're going to kind of turn like this, and the labels are going to stay there next to the axis. So we want to play with the position. So let's go back to that label drop-down menu. Instead of next to axis, I'm going to say low. That means it's going to go on the low end of the x-axis, the horizontal axis, and so that puts it on the outside there on the left side. Now, if I were to switch this axis to the high designation, that would go on the upper end. Now, this works for vertical charts too, like column charts. You can put your labels above or below your chart, or kind of in the center if you had negative values and you have an axis, you have values that go below that axis right there. Now, the other option here is to select none. And if I selected none, that would just get rid of my labels altogether and I would have no labels. But I definitely don't want that. So I'm going to go back and keep the low axis. So this is how to position your labels if you ever get in a pinch or you're creating these non-native charts in PowerPoint and all of a sudden your axis labels kind of get weird. Go ahead to that format axis pane, go to the label little dropdown and see if your positioning is correct. And go ahead and play with it to see where you want those axes. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. Had a great time making this for you, and I can't wait to see you next time.